Origin of Man. Luanda has made a new friend, Dr. Anderson, while walking home. He is crazy about history of man and is looking to encourage Luanda. They are currently walking over to the dig site. Let's see what they are talking about.
Hey, what name did you just call me? Nyanda? What? And where are we going?
I will explain the name later, once we reach my team's archaeological site and can look at that skull. But first, I would like to see how much you know about the origin of man.
Well, to be honest, that is kind of a tricky topic. At home, for example, we are told stories about Ramogi, which is a Luo story of creation. I know my Gikuyu friends have similar tales about Ngai, and my Maasai folks have Enkai.
Ah, that is specifically the oral traditions of communities and individuals. It is mostly through verbal communication, and are like myths and legends. Many early tribes have stories like this around the world, from the Māoris in New Zealand to the Mayans in the Americas. Now, what did you mean tricky?
Well, you see, when we go to church, we are taught from the Bible in the book of Genesis, chapter 1, that God created the universe, and so on. You're familiar with that tale, right?
Ah, I see now. And yes, this is dealing with the creation theory, which varies in many different religions, such as from the Quran in Islam, the Torah for the Jewish faith, and Upanishads in Hinduism. These are the books for each religion. Now, I will throw another wrench in the gears. Have you been taught about the evolution theory in school?
Yes. I believe it was Charles Darwin that came up with the term in 1959. It basically says we evolved from monkeys.
Well, that's kind of a bold statement, but his theory argued plants and animals changed from simple to complex stages through mutation, natural selection, and environmental adaptation.
A mutation is like when the lizard is affected by the atomic bomb and makes a Godzilla.
Yes, but that is the most extreme form. It is a sudden change influenced by genetics or environment. Now, natural selection can be generalized as survival of the fittest. A faster, smarter, or more resilient animal or species will win more of the limited resources.
So, environmental adaptation is the concept that humans and primates like monkeys had a common ancestor millions of years ago?
Yes, but there are many different development stages, which can be looked at as the evolution of man. Necessity is the mother of all invention, right? So somewhere along the line, we made that clear change that differs us from them.
So evolution of man took a long time.
Yes, as all evolution tends to happen. We shared a common ancestry as primates, and our specific class was Hominidae, while primates was Pongidae. This gave rise to hominoids, which were man, ape mixtures. I will explain how animals are organized when we get to the site.
Is that what you're looking for here? The fossils and bones?
Yes. My research is involving looking at early man. Archaeology is an important way to learn about him. We look at the tools and weapons left over in the area. East Africa had a lot of forest and rivers that man would utilize for their home.
So where else have you been?
I have visited a few sites in Karandusi, Olongasali, and Kubu Fora. In Tanzania, I've only been to Olduvo Gorge. But mind you, there are plenty.
Oh, you mean Olongasali and Olduvai Gorge. Okay, I get it.
Oh, yes.
There seems like a lot around here. But why? Why don't you just go back to America and Europe and look for them there?
Well, you see, Luanda, as I mentioned earlier, in Africa, the rivers, forest, lakes, and savanna grasslands were great places for man to get food. Not to mention it is warm here all year round. Ever try to live in England without a jacket?
I have never seen snow.
You aren't missing much. Ah, here we are, at the site, ready to see a skull?
Yes!